welcome to our webinar, where I would like to highlight the benefits of using ENCODE LiveWorks over spreadsheets for displaying and processing measured time series data. So, okay, I've structured my presentation like this. At the beginning, I will give a little introduction on Prensia and GlyphWorks before we head on to the challenge of gaining insights to measured time series data. And of course, I would like to highlight the benefits of using GlyphWorks and we'll show all these benefits in a live demo. And finally, I will sum this up, and at the end, you have the possibility to ask some questions, and I'm hopefully can answer them. So let's start. So for those that are not familiar with Prensia yet, Prensia is within HBK the software editor. And we take care of the software brands ENCODE for durability applications and ReliaSoft for reliability applications. And besides the software, we also offer training classes for reliability and durability applications, theory classes, and software hands-on. And beside that, we also offer services. For example, we do have our own materials testing lab in the UK where we can characterize materials for you. So this is an overview over the Prensia software portfolio. On the left-hand side in red, these are the ReliaSoft tools. Maybe the most popular are Vibol for live data analysis, and BlockSim for system reliability modeling. But today we'll look at the ENCODE software, and especially we'll have a closer look at GlyphWorks and VibeSys for processing time series data. So what I would like to show today is how we get from a huge list of numbers to answers. What can we get out of our data by using GlyphWorks in comparison to spreadsheet programs like Excel, for example? So first, a little intro to GlyphWorks. GlyphWorks is our data processing system that comes along with a lot of predefined analysis tools. The user interface is a completely graphical and interactive, so all the processes are built together via drag and drop. There is no coding at all necessary, and it's very powerful in analyzing a huge amounts of data, multi-channel data, as we will see in a minute. So when it comes to data analysis, the first thing is you have to import our time series data. And GlyphWorks supports natively around 40 different binary file formats. So there is no need for any kind of translation or a conversion into CSV or something. It just reads the native file formats. Using binary file formats has another advantage. First, of course, is that they are much faster in the process, in the data analysis itself. But they also support additional features, for example, metadata. Yeah, GlyphWorks is very good in super fast displaying of time series data. It offers lots of functionality like zooming, overlays, you can position cursors. But it also offers 3D plots, for example, to visualize rainflow histograms. GlyphWorks has the ability to automatic detect relevant sections for our data analysis, like it's highlighted at the top right corner. And also GlyphWorks offers a lot of tools for data reduction, for example, rainflow cycle counting or time at level countings. the software comes along with a lot of help and support. With the software, you get a complete detailed software documentation that does not only cover software handling itself, but it also has several theory handbooks with it, for example, for fatigue theory. And if you still have questions, you can get support from our experienced application engineers like myself and my colleagues. And another big advantage of using Glyphworks is that we can easily share these analysis workflows, and they are very easy to use. If you email it to a colleague, for example, he can right away use this data analysis workflow. So let's head to the software. And in the upcoming live demo, I would like to show you how binary data files are imported and how fast and flexible the displays of Glyphworks are to display multi-channel time series data. After that, I'll show you how you can use data reduction tools for even better visualization and interpretation of our data. And we will create complex analysis workflows without a single line of code. And finally, storing and sharing of these workflows is very important. And the last thing I would like to demo is the overall philosophy of the software that we would like to get from raw data to a report with a single mouse click, basically. So let me stop the presentation here and go to the software. So I have already started the software, and the first thing what Glyphworks does when it's started up, it scans through a predefined working directory and shows me all the data it recognizes in this working directory. So these data is shown in the so-called available data window. And already at this stage, I have a lot of visualization possibilities. For example, I can pick one of these data sets that were found, can open it up. All the collected data channels are available. And from there, I can maybe select the ones I'm interested in. And then I can click on the viewer button for a quick preview of my data. And as I said, everything you need to do on the visual side can be done with this viewer. I can zoom in. I can do overlay plots. And of course, I can return to the full screen mode easily. And if needed, I could also add maybe some cursors. And then these cursors will show me the data values, and I can easily shift them around in my data sets. So without doing a single analysis, I have a complete access to my data graphically. And maybe a few words about the user interface. So we have introduced the available data window on the very left side that holds all of our data we want to analyze. On the far right hand side, we have the so-called Glyph palette, where we find all the analysis functions that are available for my data analysis. Yeah, and in the middle, the big white screen is what we call the workspace. And there we'll create our data analysis workflows. And I will show you how this works. As I said, there is no coding needed. Everything is drag and drop. So I can take one of my measurements. Again, it's a multi-channel measurement. And in this case, I take the whole data set. drag it onto the workspace. And also the time series input glyph has the visualization capabilities needed to get a first impression visually on your data. You can scroll through all the channels you have collected and get a first impression about your data. And now let's create a very simple analysis workflow. I pick one of my analysis tools or glyphs, how we call them, from the palette. In this case, let's do a simple arithmetic operation. And then I just need to connect the glyphs with the pipes. And if we just want to visualize our results, we do not need to save it to disk. We just need to display. In this case, it's again a XY display. And then we have created a very little process. And the important thing to keep in mind is that every glyph has its individual properties. And these properties control how the analysis is actually done. So in this case, let's do a multiplication. And so that we can see that something's changing, we multiply it with -1. So we just turn it around and then we'll execute it. And as you can see, we have now the speed, for example, is going down in the negative direction. And this is how you would set up your data analysis workflows, simply by dragging and dropping glyphs on the workspace, connecting them and setting the properties right. And now it's very important to note that all these data analysis processes you create here, including all the properties you set, can be saved and reused at a later time, or these workflows are saved as a flow file, and they are very small, so you can email it to colleagues so that they can also do these kind of analysis. And for the rest of the demo, I will also use predefined workflows to save some time. So in this case, I'm not saving this here. And the first workflow I'm showing you is the data reduction side. So especially when your time series data gets large, it's very important to have a good classification methods. So in this case, what we can do, again, we can take the whole data set, take it to the TS input glyph and visualize it again, as we have already seen. Then this test splitter is taking care of getting me only the strain channels out of my measured data. And then I'll execute this predefined workflow. And what I get is a frequency spectra, a PSD of my measured channels, and below we'll have a Rankine cycle counting in a range mean format, and it's a 3D histogram. And also with this PSDs, for example, you have again visualization options for overlaying the data. You can of course look at it separately, and again with this arrow button you can scroll through the data. By default, only 4 channels are displayed, but of course also this can be changed up to 16 channels at one time, and in some cases even more. Yeah, and maybe also a word on the 3D histogram display, because this is a very nice feature that this is completely interactive, this display. So especially when you're dealing with 3-dimensional data sets, it can be very helpful for the interpretation that you can choose the position of the histogram just to your needs. I mean, now you could say, okay, it's a fairly small data set, but I have also created a larger data set. So, which represents, it's a 21 channel data set. It represents about 35 to 40 minutes of field measurement, let's say. And each channel has around 920,000 data points, which would push tools like Excel really to its limits. But again, I can just take this data set. So the long one is here. Take the long one. You see, it's lots and lots of data. Without zooming in, it would be very hard to read. But with these classification tools here, I just execute my workflow, and it will come up within a second with the results. Again, we have a frequency spectra displayed, and also the range mean histograms. And again, this is a huge, fairly huge data set with 35 minutes of continuous measurement. So it's very powerful, GlyphWorks, even with large multi-channel data sets, and very flexible. But it's not only analyzing this data in this way. What we also can do is associate our data with additional information. For example, GPS and video data. So again, that's always the same. We can work with the whole data set that we have collected, drag it onto the time series input glyph. And if we run the workflow, the first thing what we see is that our GPS position is plotted on a map. And I also overlaid the GPS position with the speed of the car. And finally, to understand what's really happening, you can synchronize all this data with a video you have collected. And now, in this video player, I just can run the video, and I hope you can see it smoothly via a WebEx now. And what you should see is the car driving, and at the same time, the cursor on the GPS map is moving. And also on my displayed data channel, there is also a cursor moving in my display. And so with this help, you can really identify when and where something is happening and how is what happening, because you can see it on the video. And the video player itself, I think, is capable to display six videos in parallel. So you can have, let's say, six cameras on your car. Okay. So I'm not saving this here now because it's already finished. Yeah, but coming back to Excel for a minute, even Excel data is supported within GlyphWorks. So, of course, what we could do when we look at the properties, or first of all, let's select the Excel file I've prepared. In this case, I'm reading in metadata via Excel. But if you look at the properties of the Excel input glyph, it's also very flexible. Not only metadata is supported via Excel, but really measurement data in Excel format can be read into the software. But I decided to demo the metadata feature from the Excel input glyph, because Excel can be of very great help when analyzing the data. For example, lots of the measurement projects we do are documented with Excel sheets things like that. And it contains lots of important information we can use for our data analysis. And even if it's not readily available, these metadata in Excel format, we as a user can, within seconds, create such a simple table and then pipe this information into our data analysis workflow and use it for further analysis, for further decision-making, things like that. So again, I can take one of our data sets, take it into our software, and then at this point, I will more or less merge the additional information coming from Excel with our time series data still in a binary format. So I execute this, and in the display for metadata, we can now see that this additional information is available with our original data set. And for the further data analysis, for example, I can tell the software now, look for all track conditions that were dry. And the software will automatically search all data sets that contain this information and find those with the dry weather conditions. Okay, I have a last analysis prepared for you. This is supposed to highlight the overall philosophy of the software, which is from raw data to a report with one click, let's say. So Glyphworks comes along with a displaying and reporting tool, which we call Studio. And this is highly configurable, so you can create your own report layouts with the information you need for your work. And the idea is that we take our complete data set again, and then we'll do the needed data analysis. In this case, we do an amplitude distribution, again, rain flow cycle counting, and a PSD calculation. And we have entered our data. We just press the run button, and it more or less immediately will create the report for us. And this is a single channel report in this case, but it's again, it's highly configurable to your needs. And when you are still interactively working with the software, you can scroll through the channels and look at all the results of the individual channels. And as I know that Excel is still a very important tool for lots of us, there is another display I would like to highlight here. We call it the data value display. This enables you at any point in your data analysis process to get access to the numbers like we know it from Excel. So for example, I connected here with the raw data and I immediately get the numbers from all the channels that are in my data set. And from here, I can export it right away to CSV format to Excel. And this is now the time series data. But this is, of course, as I said, valid or possible for also the reduced data. Let's have a look at the frequency spectra, for example. We connect it. And then and we get all the information of the frequency spectra for all my channels in this spreadsheet style. And again, it's ready to export to CSV file or to Excel. Okay, that's my software demo. So let's get back to the PowerPoints and sum this up a little bit. So I hope I could highlight some of the biggest benefits that Glyphworks offers compared to spreadsheet programs like Excel. And with Glyphworks, engineers have access to really fast displaying tools for measure time series data in a lot of different ways. May it be overlaid, may it be zooms, cursors, everything is there, and you can configure it so that you get the best out of your data. And I also showed how easy it is to create the data analysis processes, everything without coding. And these processes can be stored, reused, and shared via email, for example, with other colleagues. And due to the workflow style, they are easily understood by the colleagues. And if you want to do more detailed analysis, there are dedicated tools available, for example, frequency analysis or fatigue calculations, all within the software package, let's say. And I would like to point out also tools like Excel are not really for free. I mean, and it's in all cases the most expensive part of this is possibly the engineer spending time analyzing the data in a non-efficient environment. And even if you can create scripts there, the creation of the scripts takes time, maintaining these scripts takes time, and also explaining them to other users is time consuming.